Are AWS certifications worth it in 2024? Well, it's definitely a very competitive job market this year, but certifications are still a great way to validate your skills and showcase them to employers, as well as being a great structure in order to help you to learn a certain technology. Now, there is a little bit more to it because it is a competitive environment. So I'm going to go through a few tips that I've got in terms of what you should be doing, what you should be thinking about, and how you should be structuring your training and making the right decisions so that you can be successful in the job market this year. So I'm Neil Davis. I'm the founder of Digital Cloud Training. I've trained over 750,000 people online in cloud computing. Now, in this video, I'm going to cover 5 different tips that I've got in terms of what you need to do this year to get ahead in the cloud industry. Make sure you stay to the end because the last one's probably the most important one. Okay, so tip number one, if you are new to the tech industry or you're transitioning from a non-cloud role into cloud, it's a useful idea to start with the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner certification. That is the foundational level certification. It's pretty easy. And if you do have some IT background, it's going to be relatively straightforward for you, but it does still hold quite a bit of credibility with employers. So good for those who are new because it's a great on-ramp to the more difficult certifications. And if you are a little bit more advanced in terms of your technology expertise, it should be relatively easy for you to get, so why not go for it? The other thing about the Cloud Practitioner is it's also designed for people who come from non-tech backgrounds or do non-tech roles. So you might be a project manager, you might be a business development manager, you might be in sales, but you're working with cloud technology, so it's useful to get that cert. So again, that's the one for you if you're from a non-tech role, so non-hands-on. Now, the second tip is at the associate level, there are now 4 associate certifications. My previous advice was to go for all of the AWS associate certifications because there's so much overlap between what were the 3 before. Those are the Solutions Architect Associate, the Developer Associate, and the SysOps Administrator Associate. A lot of overlap between those certifications. So once you've got one, it's a lot easier to get the next one and the next one. And the order I always recommend is Solutions Architect first, then Developer, then do the SysOps. Now there's a new one, so it's muddied the waters a little bit. We now have the AWS Certified Data Engineer Associate. The thing about this certification is it seems to me to be a bit more specialist. All of them are tailored for specific job roles, architect roles, developer roles, or operations roles. But the Data Engineer Associate does seem to be a lot more difficult. I've done the beta exam. It was a lot more difficult than any other associate level exam I've done from AWS. So I wouldn't necessarily recommend that unless you're specifically going into data engineering roles. Okay, so tip number 3. There are 2 professional level certifications and there's several specialty certifications. Now, I recommend that you take these exams only if you are a little bit more advanced. So for example, if you're a solutions architect today and you're transitioning into the cloud, it's probably worthwhile going right the way up to the solutions architect pro level, but make sure you get the associate level first, otherwise it's a really difficult exam. Likewise with DevOps Pro, if you are a DevOps engineer, you're transitioning into cloud, learning AWS, why not go for the pro level? It's gonna give you a little bit more credibility at the level that you are in your career at the moment. Now, for other people who are a bit more of a beginner, sure, you can get those. It might give you some, extra juice in terms of when you're trying to look for jobs, employers might be impressed by it, but I think it's more important to concentrate on diversifying your skills a bit. We're going to talk about that in a moment. So don't necessarily try and get the top-level certification straight away. Now, for the specialties, those are more where your job role is aligned to that specialty certification. If you come from a networking background, you might want to do the AWS Certified Advanced Networking specialty. Again, do the associate level certifications first, at least one of them. Otherwise, you just won't understand some of the AWS terminology and the services for which you are applying the networking concepts. So just assess whether those certifications are going to be beneficial for you in your particular stage of your career. Tip number 4 is that you do need to diversify your skill set. AWS alone is not going to cut it today. So even if you end up with several AWS certifications, you might end up in an interview and the interviewer is going to ask you about Linux, they're going to ask you about Docker, they're going to ask you about Kubernetes and maybe try and test some programming or some scripting skills. And if you don't have that skill set, then you're going to be in a bit of a problem. So what I recommend is that you diversify your skill set. So going a bit more broad rather than too deep and look at the job descriptions for the type of role that you're going for and have a look at what's required. Typically, we're going to see things like Linux, we're going to see Python on there, we're going to see Kubernetes quite often. There might be some other programming skills depending on the role that you're going for. And there could be other technologies like Jenkins and Ansible as well into the sort of DevOps world. So go broader rather than going deep. Make sure you've got the skills that employers are actually looking for. Now, on that note, we have our Cloud Mastery Bootcamp, which is a live training program, and that's exactly what we do for our students. So through several months of live training, we teach them AWS, they earn multiple certifications, we teach them Linux, we teach them Python programming, we teach them infrastructure as code with Terraform, really important technology, almost everyone out there is using it today. And we teach them containers and Kubernetes as well. So all super important technologies, whether you're going for cloud engineering roles, solutions architect roles, DevOps roles, almost whatever role that you're going for, you're going to see on many job descriptions those same technologies. My last tip is to make sure that you've got hands-on experience that you can showcase to employers. So you need to make sure that you've got some skills, some practical capability that employers can actually see in some way, whether that's in the form of an article or a GitHub repository that you can share with them. Or maybe it's just you talking through what you've done and explaining the problems that you encountered and how you solved those problems. See, this tells employers that you're not just somebody who is able to pass certification exams by memorizing facts. Okay, you actually have to have some hands-on capability. Now, if you are new to the industry and you haven't worked in the industry, or you're transitioning into cloud but you haven't worked specifically with cloud technology, how do you have that experience? Well, you can do your own projects. It doesn't have to be on the job experience. That's always better. But of course, we all have to start somewhere. And employers know that, and they recognize that, and they recognize also the ambition and the character that you've got through what you've been doing outside of the industry as well. So if you're doing lots of projects in your own time and documenting them and showcasing them in some way, that's definitely very impressive to employers. So again, quick plug for our Cloud Mastery Bootcamp. One of the most important things that we do in the live training and how it differentiates itself from the on-demand online training that we have is that hands-on capability through lots of live lab exercises and projects that our students actually complete. And then we teach them how they can showcase those to employers. So they've actually got a really strong portfolio of experience that they can demonstrate to employers, even if they've never worked in the industry before. Now, you can do that as well. You can find projects online. You can just try and come up with your own ideas and then work out how you're going to showcase that. How can you have some kind of online presence which you can show to employers so that you can demonstrate that you've got those hands-on skills. And that's it for this video. I hope that was useful to you, and I wish you a very successful 2024.